Hello everybody and welcome back to the Let's Plays of the Railroad Tycoon 3 scenarios. Got a new scenario for you today, obviously an expert. It's the Chicago to New York scenario, which does actually come with the original game. It's not an expansion pack scenario, it's not one I've downloaded or anything. And you can start in 1900, 05 or 1910, so I'm going to start in 1905 by default. And by default there's one AI, and you can't have any other thing other than one AI. You have to have one AI. So let's just get on with it. So as the name suggests, you have to connect the cities of Chicago and New York, so playing in eastern United States. It's a fairly big map and it's a pretty interesting scenario as well. Nothing ridiculously difficult, but at the same time, it's not really easy either. So it's actually a pretty fun scenario. So you get 25 years to connect New York and Chicago and St. Louis and industry profit of 5 million and Chattanooga and haul 50 loads of rails. No, it's not one company, no, it's not buying or selling, no company mergers. Yes, and no unconnected track. So, we don't have to worry about stock or personal net worth, and therefore we don't have to worry about dividends, so we can just concentrate all the money onto the company. Which is, from my perspective, a very good thing, because I'm not that good at personal net worth. Yeah, I think I'm on. Yeah, I'm on the wrong way. Good thing is, you do start with a lot of money. Right, as for actual, like, starting locations, there's a very profitable textile mill in Raleigh, with a lot of cotton and no wool. Big pile of stuff in Dyersburg. Again, cotton and wool. Charleston has a lot of coal, not a lot of iron. Normally, in Norfolk, you get a textile mill, but it's in Raleigh at the moment. Also, what's in Winston-Salem? A textile mill. Ah. So we could build between, we could build a line like that. Or could take advantage of Dyersburg and do like Memphis to Dyersburg, because Memphis does demand cars, so Memphis is a city we will eventually want to connect to. It's also nice and flat over there. We do need to get to St. Louis anyway, although St. Louis is pretty useless at the moment. These are all options that we can go with. Actually, starting in Chicago or New York seems a bit pointless because there isn't that much we can do with them. I'm looking at that and I'm thinking that's a very profitable textile mill. That's a very nice textile mill. Whereas, so is that. Chattanooga, Knoxville, blah blah blah. This gives us easier access to like New York and then like down the East Coast. you can build up a pretty nice empire and then kind of connect over to Chattanooga. By comparison, that doesn't really give us a lot of options because there's kind of nothing over there apart from Dyersburg itself. So I'm thinking just build over here and then connect like along there. And I'm probably going to buy that textile mill as well if I can afford it. Is there anything in Norfolk? There's a distillery. But there's like, there's some sugar, but that distillery is not going to do anything. What's in Charlotte? If we had lumber, that'd be okay, but we don't. But there's a lumber mill in Chattanooga. I don't know, I think I'm just going to connect these two up together. Just see how that plays out. I think I've got a bit unlucky with the seed, the seed for this particular run through. Because normally when I play this game, or this particular scenario, there is actually a textile mill in Norfolk itself. But yeah, that is actually fine. There's also a brewery there. No? A distillery, sorry. So I'm getting a bit of sugar, but it's not really doing much. But yes, that should be okay, and then probably buy this textile mill. 2 million, that is expensive. That one's 1.8 million. Debatable as to which one's actually more profitable. For 60... That one's more profitable, so... Although that one's also damn good, so I don't know. Probably just buy the cheaper one. Yeah. Deal, but it's okay, I guess. The main thing is that most of our money for this year will actually come from that textile mill. I mean, we are making profit. It's just mostly from the textile mill. But that's fine. Profit is profit. And where do we connect to next? That is a good question. Roanoke, maybe? That has a very profitable looking lumber mill, actually. Because there's nearby logging camps, and then... If we connect it up to Charlotte, that'd be a... Nah. If we connect it up to Charlotte... Seems this is running low on material. Probably don't have enough to connect up to there. 11%, that's pretty ugly. But, let's just take it out. Yeah, let's just try anyway. a lot of hills. No, that's okay. It's not ideal, but it's about as good as it's going to get. Apart from that little hill there. I'm sure we'll survive. Turns out I don't really need the bond. Right. Both of those are actually okay. Big profit. I'm also going to need facilities. I could do that. Good. I can still upgrade to a large if I wanted to, but Roanoke isn't big enough for a large, so that's fine. Quickly save the game actually. Yeah, I tried recording this previously and as a let's play and I got blue screen of death, so I'm not very happy about that, so this is actually like take two. It was annoying as well because I was probably on track for getting gold. Obviously on expert, like this is on expert right now. Yeah, so I wasn't exactly very happy because I was about an hour into the recording thinking, oh yeah, I think it was about 1916 or something. So I was probably only like halfway through the actual scenario, but and I recorded like an hour, but yeah, blue screen of death, so I wasn't very happy. Why do I need to forget? I need to remember to not click that because it didn't do anything. Come on. Give me money. There we go. Right. I actually have a lot of money now. Because we made a lot of money last year. Yeah, that line is pretty successful. Textile mill seems to be doing well as well. Could, in theory, actually upgrade that for more money. Yeah, probably do want to upgrade that, actually. And take out a bond. Connect on over to Charlotte. I hope we've got enough. Probably not going to have enough money, actually. You never know. I actually got just enough. Awkward, but that's okay. Where is Rally getting lumber from? I guess it's going maybe to Winston-Salem and then to Rally? I don't know. It's a bit weird, that. Anyway. Can't get passengers. Or mail. Can deliver alcohol. And clothes. No lumber. It seems that's like my best bet, actually. Don't actually have enough money for the water towers and the maintenance shed. That does help. I've already done that, so. Nice money. Nice bit of wonga. Also, my track's kind of now like a 3 or a fork, depending on how you look at it. It's a bit weird that, actually. Also, I want Norfolk to build something useful, so I can connect over to it. I mean, it does have a distillery, but there's no... Well, there's already a distillery in Winston-Salem that's actually doing pretty alright, so... Seems like that was a good idea. This 5 million is easy. It's a joke, really. Like, it's so easy to obtain. Is there anything in Richmond that's actually... It's a fairly alright meat plant, but... Whereas my best bet just kind of saving up and waiting for Chattanooga, but that's going to cost like several million. Let's just check out a big bond. I don't know, these trains don't seem as profitable as normal for some reason. Oh, for God's sake, hurry up. Actually, I'm probably... Yeah, probably want to double track some of this up. Which bit in particular? Especially around, yeah, around here. And then up to Winston-Salem. Ooh, sheep farm. Ooh. I mean, it's kind of... It provides wool, but will it actually start appearing on my lines? I don't know. Probably not. But it might. It's making its way over, I guess. Just a matter of time before it actually gets there. You're right, this year, why are we not making money? Come on, trains, what are you doing? Wasn't a great year. I've got to wait for that. How much is it going to cost me to build a massive rail line like that? Probably a fair bit. The problem is Richmond isn't doing anything of importance or value. Although Washington DC and Baltimore would be good. And then Philadelphia, New York, Allentown... Maybe, but it's slightly hilly, so... So realistically, my best bet would actually be to connect on over to Chattanooga, but it's a long, long way. and there's not a whole lot there. And also, because hills... Like, I mean, I could in theory use a consolidation. But, like, they're really outdated. My best bet would actually be using electric. But that just increases the costs even more. So I'm going to have to take out a massive bond if I do that. That, or I wait. But my profits aren't great. That's what's annoying. Like, yeah, we only have 3 trains, but I don't know. I just kind of need more money. At least now traffic should be alright. Like, traffic should not be an issue anymore. Alright, let's just take out 1 million in cash. Build an electric line between Charlotte and hopefully Chattanooga. We'll just see how that goes. Okay. Yeah, this is where the going gets tough. Because of gradients and whatnot. Too bad. Well, that's a bit... Yeah. Wait, what the heck is... No. We can't be dealing with this. It's not, like, terrible, but it's just also not ideal. It's an interesting line, so... Consider it. I can't remember what I'm going to do actually. That's not ideal either. Yeah, this isn't easy, if I'm gonna admit, this is not easy. That may actually be as good as it gets. It's not ideal there, but it's not ideal there, but that's pretty good, I reckon. I've actually got a fair amount of funds left. Right, hang on. I need to think about that. I need to think about station placement as well. Just accept all that. That would work, but... I need something... Definitely need a large station. Something like that. And then it covers almost the entire city. And there's a load of lumber and logs which come from Roanoke, but that's miles away. Nobody wants to go to Chattanooga, which is interesting. But we can ship stuff to and from Charlotte, which is as I planned. Make decent cash. We also need maintenance and service towers. So that's okay. It still actually maintains decent speed. In fact, it's pretty fast. It's quite ideal, actually. Chattanooga pays a fortune for clothes. It's just a shame that I don't... Also pays a fortune for alcohol. If I could get... I mean, how bad is the gradient? It's actually not that bad, so an 8-wheeler might be able to do it. Or I could use a camelback, which is... How much would it cost to just electrify everything? Not that much. 569,000. So it's actually... Okay, that's interesting. It's cheaper to just electrify the whole thing than it is to do it individually. Don't know if that's game design or game bug, I don't know. It should make a lot of money, which it does. Last year was a decent year, though. The money is starting to come in now. An electric train. These electric trains, don't underestimate them. Okay, they're not good for passengers, but considering they've got supposedly poor acceleration, their acceleration's actually pretty good. They are fast. And they're good at hills, so... These little things are actually really good, and they're really cheap. Do not underestimate this little thing. For freight, it's fantastic. Right, this is really good. It's faster than the 8-wheeler. It's got better acceleration. Passengers like it more, but it's cheaper to buy, but a lot more expensive to maintain, but it is faster. So, I think for now we'll just keep the 8-wheelers. Since we don't really get a lot of passenger traffic, and we don't have enough money to necessarily upgrade anyway. Next stop is probably Knoxville, which has a warehouse, that's interesting, which demands paper and cheese. Paper is produced in Chattanooga. Interesting. Cheese is not produced anywhere, or anywhere nearby. It's produced over here, in Cleveland, and I'm guessing that's Pittsburgh? Yeah, why on earth does it demand paper and cheese? I don't have a clue. Unfortunately, that is a pretty useless town, if I'm honest. It does demand paper, which we do produce over here. Not a massive amount, unless we can get some passengers. No, I'm afraid to say that that city would be pretty useless. Unless it has logs. It will have some logs. And some pulpwood, so we could actually connect there, and after all. In fact, how is that lumber mill doing? Too expensive. Just as I suspected. That distillery is not going to do very well. Because there's no material for it to do well. There's no produce or sugar nearby. But yes, we may actually want to connect to Knoxville after all. And then from Knoxville, I don't really know. Nashville is a decent bet. There's the location of the famous, well, I say famous, it's currently trending, Bowling Green Massacre. Rest in peace to everyone who died there. I'm sure they'll be sorely missed, because it never happened. Never mind. Banter. Right, the money is actually coming in nicely. I'm thinking maybe actually build up to Washington Duke. And then Baltimore. And get a couple of Atlantics going. Or maybe Knoxville after all, I don't know. No, actually I'm going to go up to Washington Duke. We don't actually need electric just yet for this line, because we're going to be running like Atlantics and other steam locos. Oh, I already had bright lights on, but it's a bit dark. It's just because of the weather and lighting, and it's night, so in game, obviously. Yeah. Also, might as well get Baltimore while that's it. Doesn't allow any room for expansion, but it does get the whole city, so it's okay, I guess. There's a very successful textile mill in Washington itself. Don't have any money anymore, but we'll do soon. Perhaps we haven't had a prosperity yet or anything. Like, it's just been stuck on economy normal. Which I find a bit weird. Hey, there's speak of the devil, there's a prosperity. Share price is high. Must just be because we're doing pretty well. Oh shit, did I build... I built fucking electric anyway. Oh, for fuck's sake. Oh well, it's okay. It's fine. Actually, we're getting a lot of passengers along these lines. People leaving Washington and Baltimore to go to Winston-Salem. A fair amount of them, actually. Yes, I would. So yes, I'm going to use an electric train. I think for general freight, this is probably the best. Like, this is better than that. Oh no, we run out of stuff. It's not sending anything. That is impressive. That is very good. We are in an economic boom, so we are going to make more money anyway. But that is very nice. Right. Well, now I can connect up to Philadelphia and then New York. I'm going to save the game again. Thank you. That's not ideal. It says business is boom, but it doesn't actually say how, but it's good anyway, probably. That is a lot of money. Money's starting to really pile in now. We are in an economic boom, obviously, but even so, we are making a lot of money. It's because of this main line, like New York, Philadelphia, Baltimore, Washington are very profitable cities, so combine that with good trains and you just get insane profits. I'm not sure about the next destination. I mean, could go to Albany and then kind of, with the end goal of obviously getting to like Detroit and Chicago, obviously, and satisfying our goal. Or do we go this way to Knoxville and then maybe along here to like Memphis, Dyersburg, Nashville? Or do we go like up here into like Lexington? And Charleston, Cincinnati, Indianapolis, that way. Decisions. Or do I try and cut through the mountains between like Allentown and then like somehow figure out a way into Pittsburgh? That's not exactly an easy thing to do. The best thing to do would be to go around like that. Or cut through the mountains like this. Neither are necessarily easy or ideal. We do have a lot of money. I think I'm actually going to try and get to Albany. Also going to say... Well, that's like a bit weird now. That just looks stupid. Can't get rid of it. Oh dear. Right, that's okay. I'm going to save the game. Okay. So. I want to connect up to Albany. Ideally, I want a tunnel or something here, but or maybe a bridge, but it's not offering me anything. That is ideal, but it's also a fortune. That's even more expensive. Why are tunnels so expensive? Especially when you can build an obscene bridge for far, far less. Like, that's a really nice bridge, but then that is just, ugh. You know, like, ugh. Not ideal. Guess this works. Kind of do want to build though along like the riverbed, but that doesn't seem possible. Unless I can wind round down like that. Oop, too far. Seriously, if I could get a bloody tunnel... Fucking... tunnel through that, that'd be great, but obviously I can't. No, this isn't going to be good. I think whatever I do, it's not going to be ideal, but it's looking good so far. Just got to keep that up. Wow. Okay. No. No. How about no? How about not that? How about something else? How's that? That's alright. Yeah, that's pretty nice. Alright, gradient. It's not exactly, it's not perfect, but now the question is, how do I get over here? Other than some kind of horrible, horrible angle. Oh. Deleted too much. Unless I can... Yeah, now that's looking nice. The real question is, how the fuck do I get to Albany? Because look at it. It's just... Ugh. It's just... Ugh. Now, surprisingly, I don't want a tunnel. I really don't want a tunnel. That is not a nice gradient. I mean, the electric train will handle it, it's just not exactly the most ideal situation. Can avoid that. No, that's not going to work. Fuck, there's got to be an easy way of doing this. Do I cross the river again and then, like, build it over there? And, That's a pretty nice river crossing, if I do say so myself. That is a very weird-looking bridge. Okay, this isn't ideal. Oh, come on, please let me build. Seriously? You're gonna do this to me, game? Fine. Let's find a different way around. No, come on, come on. Wow, nothing works. Absolutely nothing works. And I fucking hate this. Because nothing fucking works. On the plus side, when this is built, it's gonna look very nice and impressive. But nothing fucking works. Which means I might have to go with the original strategy. As unwanted as that necessarily is. Just have interest. Alright. You see, a large station there would be perfect. It fits. It's just it won't let me build it. I guess I could get away with maybe like a large station there, and then that would fit the entire town. Let's see how that works out. Because then I might actually be able to get away with a less horrible gradient. Right, that works out okay, apart from this area, and... I'm not happy with any of this. Let that be known. I'm not happy with this. Down with this sort of thing. Ooh, hello. Have I found the... Have I found something? Fuck's sake. Why does Albany have to be built in, like, the middle of a fucking load of fucking goddamn hills? Mother of... Oh my god. Alright. Please give me something, game. Give me something to work with. Bear in mind this is all electric, so it's costing me even more than it would do normally. Ah, what the hell is that? This is all really nice, but then there's just nothing to work with. Everything just goes to shit after that. Christ. Good grief, no, no, no. I can't be dealing with this garbage. I'm gonna accept all that. I think I'm gonna save the game again. And I'm going to... If only it would let me build the station. If it would let me build the station, that'd be perfect. Because I want the station, like, right there. Even if it's like a terminal, or a terminus, rather than like a through station. It'd still be... God fucking damn it. I had something there. Maybe if I build the station... It might let me... No. No, game. Are you going to behave, or are you going to be horrible? Nope. Looks like it's going to be horrible. It's not going to let me escape from this, is it? Wow. Absolute garbage. On the plus side, that's okay. We can work with that. If I had to kind of build round like that, then that's okay. I kind of want to build a through station, which it's not letting me. Oh, no. What the hell is that? No, this ain't gonna work. I think we're just gonna have to accept that and move on. The gradient isn't that bad. It could be a lot worse, and you saw how much I struggled with that. Good grief. No, the electric train will be fine for that. I just made that worse. Maybe slightly, but not serious. Right, shitload of paper. Passengers and just all round stuff between Albany and New York. Good God, Chattanooga has a ton of logs and lumber. Philadelphia. Blimey. Philadelphia, Albany would be good. Right, I'm glad we got that sorted. Save it once more. Very glad we got that sorted. Jesus Christ, that took way longer than it should have done. But the thing is now the money flies in, and it's all worth it. Pays for itself. Well, not necessarily, but it will do in the long run, obviously. Just not immediately. And we've got new train. More expensive to buy, more expensive to maintain. Doesn't handle hills as well. It's less acceleration, worse acceleration, but it is actually significantly faster over flat land. It's got more pulling power. Less reliable, less acceleration, but for like passengers it's actually better, and I probably want to upgrade this. Just make that a... hang on, can I use some sailing? Okay. How many passengers does this get roughly? Okay, we want to upgrade that. Nice, we are making a fortune because of this boom. Right, that's fine. Right. Let's just save it again.